Isso. Então você click it away, tira isso daí.
Aperto close.
É, pode apertar close. Então, o homem fala muitas coisas aqui, tá? Hello, everybody, and welcome to Music and Lyrics. This is an English class with music, motivated by music, music lyrics in English. It will be a lot of fun. Music and lyrics is a concept I have developed based on a few different activities that I did throughout my career as a teacher. And it all started with something called pop song music at a binational center in Brazil. I worked at this binational center for 12 years as an English teacher. One of the things that we did was an event called Pop Song Music. It was basically using the lyrics to learn more English. Hi.
Hello.
Come on
Hi,
in.
Hello. How are you?
I'm well. I'm just preparing the broadcast so that I can have it on. I'm going to put it on.
Prepare for the show.
It's almost like that. Yes. I want to put it in the.
Olá. Tudo bem?
I want to put it on the on Brilla's website as well as my own. Might not be anyone here, but there might be a lot of people.
I bought this three songs.
Thank you. you have to tune it.
Yeah, just to verify this. It's okay.
Oh, I never knew that. So physics-wise, it's...
The song Linger, I used to sing in a low voice, low tone, but you can sing in that. Thank you.
I'm not sure how I'm gonna follow.
Oh.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes. If my voice.
Yeah, well, yeah. You wanna try this song? This.
Yeah. This is. I've always sung it using the original recording, but not trying to imitate the artist. Trying to sort of follow, because her voice is truly unique.
Yeah.
Have you heard her? Like how
yeah.
she has. It's impossible to replicate that.
No, not.
So, but I always try to sort of. Okay, so. All right. Let's give it a shot. I'd like to tell me when to come in. If you could return, don't let it burn, don't let it fade. I'm sure I'm not being rude, but it's just your attitude. It's tearing me apart, it's ruining everything. I swore I would be true. And honey, so did you. So why were you holding her hand? Is that the way we stand? Were you lying all the time? Was it just a game to you? But I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You've got me wrapped around your finger. Trying not to lie, things wouldn't be so confused, and I wouldn't feel serious. But you always really knew I just want to be with you, and I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger.
And you have a nice voice.
Thanks.
Yeah, good. Do you want to try this Beatles song?
Yeah, but I'm just gonna keep sharing it on Facebook so people can, if maybe somebody will see it and mm-hmm. we're still.
You can.
So there is a place where I can find.
Yeah, you can
find the chords.
Sure. You can put it on the Google. You put the name of the song and put the chords.
Right.
Hello Goodbye chords.
But
can you print it?
We can try to print it in there.
So I can follow this chords in front of it. Because sometimes it depends on the tune that the song is. This website, you can change the tune if you want. So before printing, you can choose the right tune for you to sing.
Mm-hmm. Okay. This one? Ultimate Guitar, is that
Hello one? Goodbye Chords. This one.
The second one. Okay. Mm-hmm. Because I don't know, I'm gonna work antonyms.
Ah.
So it's the best song to teach it. And I remember teaching five-year-olds this song and they used to sing in Brazil.
Yeah.
It's a perfect song. Yeah, it's wow. Okay, here we go.
Okay.
I should probably make it smaller so you can I wish I could breathe music.
I don't know exactly how it is.
I say no, you say stop, and I say go, go, go. Yeah, I'm just gonna go back to them. So I'm gonna clear everything.
This tone is okay for you?
I don't know. But it's funny how you can just, like, this is the part I find fascinating. That you can look at the chords and you look at this and you can. I find it fascinating, and I wish I could do the same.
You say stop,
and I say go, go, go. Oh no, you say goodbye, and I say hello, hello, hello. Even if you don't play it, it's fine because
okay, no problem.
It's mostly the antonyms. Yes, no, hello, goodbye, hi, stop, go. Alright.
Uh-huh. Okay. I have to
So what we can do is we can take the other ones that we were set to do want to. Because this one, I never used any instrumentals for it. I always just sing it a cappella.
I can prepare it for the next time.
It's all good. It's all good. I do have Don't Go Breaking My Heart, but I think I suck at it. It's very difficult.
This one is not that easy as it seems, but can we try?
Time after time.
Time after time.
Okay. I thought.
I'll do something.
But you sort of had to tell me when to come in, because
climbing
my bed, I hear the clock tick and think of you. Thought I've been circles, confusion is nothing new. Flashback. Almost left behind. slow, I fall behind. The second hand unwinds. If you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you, I'll be waiting. Time after time. Time after time. If you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you.
Okay, this, the problem is, okay, we have four, two times the same two sentences, okay,
mm-hmm.
Four. So we have this session four times, and then we have an instrumental part like this, just like the introduction. I got it.
Watching through windows, ring if I'm okay. Secret stolen. Alright, so you did something
this
different
part,
there.
It's not
okay, because you did something different there from bottoms. Or instead of. Okay, secret stolen from deep inside. Instead of see. No.
Yeah.
Oh, alright. So alright.
This part has a pause here. It's like a secret stolen from deep inside. The drum beats all around time.
If you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you, I'll be waiting. Time after time. All right, so there is something in between.
Yeah, just a pause.
Yeah, all right. Yeah,
this
I didn't know.
Yeah, all right. This notation is simplified. The right notation should be with this score.
All right, so there.
This notation is simplified.
This is like a book, and then you abridge the book to simplify. All right.
Yeah,
I get it.
The simplified notation. So the right notation should be those with all this scores,
right.
With this note. But to read this, you have to have a training, a special training.
Right.
But it's fine. It's okay.
Mm-hmm.
When you know the song, like we know. But this part here, this refrain is like if you lost, you can
find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you, I will be too. Time after time.
You know,
look and you will find me. Time after time.
If you fall, I will catch you, I will
be. Do I go straight into it? Okay, so there is a pause. If you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Pause. Then time after time. Then.
I, if you want, because you have four, four cycles like this.
This is what I was asking, if I go straight into it.
Lost,
you can look and you will find me. Time after time.
If you want,
look at you. Oh, I can. No, I can't do that one.
Time.
You do that.
Time
after time.
I will fazer uma parte do metal aqui. Aí volto. Aí vai na segunda parte. Aí nessa segunda parte tem um segredinho aqui, quer ver?
Coming.
Yes, we know each other.
How are you?
Fine, and you?
Good. Sure, yeah. 100% of the audience.
That's wonderful. Would you want to add one thing?
Say it again.
Well, I don't know. Some people could show up. I promoted it around Facebook and Twitter. Not sure.
You can sing along.
Yeah. You know Cindy Lauper, right?
Yeah. You have this.
You like her?
Yeah.
Cindy Lauper?
Yeah.
So this is one of her most famous songs.
Time after time. If you want to participate, if you want to participate.
Yeah, I gave her. So you guys knew each other from?
Yeah, because she's a Sydney's classmate.
Of course. All right.
We met in Sociedad once.
The bar.
I forgot the name.
Amaya.
Amaya is from a Spanish language country.
I'm from the Basque country.
But you have to know Spanish. you know.
But it's always like, for example, when people will say to me, "Oh, you're Portuguese," and I always reply, "No, I'm not Portuguese. I'm Brazilian.
I speak Portuguese.
But when people say you're Portuguese, I react the same way.
Yeah.
I think you do too.
Actually, I speak Basque, so I have our language.
Okay.
So we speak also Spanish, but our language is in Basque.
Okay.
That is completely different from
Spanish. I have no idea. I went to Barcelona the other day, which is Catalonia.
Catalonia, that's
another language over there.
Yeah, Catalonia.
Very complicated. But it's interesting.
Yeah, I understand that for foreigners,
you can speak Spanish better, much better than me. That's what I guess.
I can't speak Portuguese, so I'm looking forward.
It's all good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'll do this part twice as a tradition. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm. Are you ready?
Lying in my bed, I hear the clock tick and think of you. Caught up in circles, confusion is nothing new. Flashback, warm nights, almost like behind. Suitcases of memories, time after. Sometimes you picture me, I'm walking too far ahead. You're calling to me, I can't hear what you've said. When you say go slow, I fall behind. The second hand of mine. If you're lost, if you're looking, you will find me. Time after time, if you fall, I will catch you, I'll be waiting. Time after time, you can look and you will find me. Time after time, if you fall, I will catch you, I'll be waiting. Time after time, time after time. Your face and darkness has turned to gray, watching through windows, you're one. that you won't be waiting. Time after time, in love you look and you will find me. Time after time, before I look at you, I will be here. Start with is a song that we haven't really rehearsed, but it's all good because I remember when I started teaching English, I had little students because I was really young, so they didn't want to give me a group full of grown-ups. They gave me the little kids, they're five. And this song by the Beatles, the entire concept is on the board. It's the opposite, the antonyms. Yes, no, hello, goodbye, high, low. So the song I remember because it was so difficult for them to remember. We did this for yes, this for no, and then hello, a nod. I don't know if a nod does a nod mean hello in some cultures. In your culture, if you go like that, sort of, it's like a nod, like, you know, and a smile. That's a hello, and then a goodbye. Either this or this. Mm-hmm. I remember in New Zealand they do this for goodbye.
Yeah,
it's way too much.
Yeah, it's too much.
And then high, low, stop, go. And just one little note on this one. This can also mean hello in some cultures.
Hi.
You know why?
No.
In some cultures, right now they're talking about this in America a lot, about making marijuana legal.
Mm-hmm.
So because of this, all the people who smoke marijuana, they say hi to each other. When they type to each other, they write hi like that. Mm-hmm. So it's hi, I'm high. Mm-hmm. It's like saying hello and telling people that they have smoked something and then they're feeling high.
But you know, we have this hi as a
yes. As just saying hello.
Just saying hello, yeah.
Yeah, but hi, here, this is only in marijuana culture.
Mm-hmm.
Hi. Okay. So people say hello like that. Hi, low.
Mm-hmm.
Stop, go.
And you say hi when you have taken something.
Yeah, you can say like, oh, I'm so sorry right now. I took some pills. I'm high.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm high on pills.
Mm-hmm.
You can be high on pills, you can be high on anything, on any substance.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Champagne.
It goes straight to your head.
Mm-hmm.
This,
yeah.
Well, when something goes straight to your head, it means that you're high, like you're in a state. You're under the influence of something. It goes.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a good expression, to go straight.
Straight.
To one's head. So here you can insert where it says one's head. Go straight. My, his, her. You look at somebody and you say, oh, look at David. He's so high.
Yeah.
You know, he took some pills and he went straight to his head.
Mm-hmm.
Straight to his head. So high, low. So I'm gonna.
Maybe you could play this song.
Yeah, I'm going to put the, I found this video and I couldn't believe, my mom used to say that Ringo was her favorite Beatle.
The song was written from the 60s. And
yeah, and my mom said Ringo was her favorite Beatle.
Ringo Starr.
Yeah.
The drummer.
I never thought anything much
of
him.
Is it?
It's just Ringo and Paul now.
Ringo and Paul now, yeah.
Who's the other one again?
Huh?
Ringo, Paul
McCartney. Paul
McCartney. And then
and
John Lennon, of course.
Ringo Starr. I think it's alive. It's alive.
There is a rumor. I don't know. Have you heard this on the internet? They say that a rumor about Ringo that some point in the 70s,
mm-hmm.
he died and they substituted him for somebody else. there's a lot of stories, and there are some people that have theories that have written books and blogs about it. Where they say, no, look
yeah.
at the picture, compare.
People used to say he's the luckiest.
The luckiest Beatle.
Luckiest one, because he didn't play very, very well.
Yeah.
At the same level as his partners, because
mm-hmm.
he had very lucky in
to be in that group.
Okay, I respect him. I'm a drummer also. I respect him as a drummer, but at the certain point, he was very lucky
to be in there.
To be in that.
A part of that, one of the biggest.
Yeah.
At some point, they were said to be more famous than Jesus Christ. The Beatles. They have said, yeah.
John Lennon. Did
you like John Lennon?
I admire him. Very good songs, but I think the most. Brave one is Paul McCartney.
Paul McCartney.
Yeah. There are some controversy about them, Paul and John Lennon, as a kind of, they had a kind of competition or rivalry. Yes,
mm-hmm.
rivalry. But good, very good artists. All of them.
Here's the song, and it's I wish that there were something we could do, like to buy an account on YouTube, so you didn't have to see the ads. The ads are always louder, and
like
some of them
boring.
You can't skip
no.
until 20 seconds into
yeah.
it.
Yeah,
so it's
boring.
Yeah,
it's how to make a
make
possible,
a sale.
To make possible. To have this
for free, they have to get they
yeah.
have to have the ads. All right, they go straight into the song.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Here we go.
Hey, no, you say stop. I say go, go, go. And I say hello. Don't know why you say goodbye. I say hello. Don't know why you say goodbye. I say hello. Say hello. You are wise. And I say I don't know. I say hello, hello. I say goodbye, I say hello. I say goodbye, I say hello. Say hello, hello. Don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. Hello. Don't know why you say goodbye, I say hello. I say no, you say stop. No. You say goodbye. Oh, don't know why you say goodbye. I say hello. Why you say goodbye? I say hello. Don't know why you say goodbye. I say hello.
It's fun because I remember the little ones and singing, and I met someone in the streets when I was in Brazil years ago, and then the mom and the boy was in his 20s. He was 5 when I taught him, and then she says, "This was your English teacher," and then he said, "No, I'm sorry, I don't remember you at all, but I remember the song." He used to sing. He sang it throughout his life. So he remembered the song, but he didn't remember me. He was 5.
Yeah.
Anyway, so antonyms are opposite ideas. And in Portuguese, it's antônimos.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same in Spanish, is it?
Antônimos.
So, and I find it very helpful to have a language like Portuguese, Italian, Spanish as your first language, because those are rich languages.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah,
these words like antonyms, synonyms, for us, they're like, oh, okay, I know what that is.
Yeah.
But for an American or an English person, you might be like, what is that? Because it's not commonplace to use.
Mm-hmm.
So you know that you can say commonplace as in it's not very normal or very usual.
Mm-hmm.
It's not commonplace.
How do they call this kind of words? Antonymous? No. Another word? They have another word?
Opposite.
Opposite.
Yeah.
Opposite.
Opposite concepts.
Mm-hmm. This is what they say. So if you say opposites, they know what you're talking about if they're an English speaker, a native English speaker.
Mm-hmm.
But then, you know, antonyms is the official name for it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, we practice linger and we practice, now there's Don't Go Breaking My Heart.
Yeah.
Wow.
Do you have that one?
Yeah.
Yeah? Here we go.
Unwind. When you have a watch, I don't know, what kind of watch do you have, Mike?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you don't wind it.
Yes,
no, but your watch is not a. I'm talking about those
movies
you
no,
have
no.
to wind.
Yeah.
Sorry.
To unwind.
Unwind.
Is when you
yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Unwind.
Okay.
To unwind.
Unwind. What do you mean to unwind in terms of the dialogue?
To unwind.
It's,
for example, you
unwind.
Can say, you know, I've been so busy at work. I went out with my friends and had some drinks just to unwind, to decompress, to relax,
to relax, unwind. Oh, okay. Yeah, I saw it in a lyric, in a song.
Unwind.
Do you want to try Don't Go Breaking My Heart?
Yeah, let's try it. It's
okay.
A difficult song for me,
yeah.
But we'll try.
It's not easy. This second part is for the lady and the first part is for the man. But we can. You can sing all the parts.
Yeah.
So I will do just like.
Somebody tries to grab you.
Yeah, the first is BF and the other one is V.
Is a V.
Yeah.
Get off of me. So to take the weight off of me.
But it's not easy to sing.
Yeah.
It's take the weight off of me. Oh, honey, I got a breath. Oh, I give you my key.
So you can say something like that, the weight has been lifted off of my shoulders, to take away, like you're feeling stressed and worried about something, and it says, oh, don't worry, everything's going to be okay, so you took the weight off of me. You make me calm. You make me feel relaxed. It's when somebody helps you unwind.
Yeah, the song is very interesting.
Especially with this don't go breaking. This type of structure can also be used with don't be doing that. For example, if you want to give somebody advice before they go somewhere, you can say, when you get there, don't forget to take off your shoes. Or you can also say, don't be walking in there with your shoes on. Don't be doing whatever. Yeah. Don't be doing this. Don't be doing this. It's like saying don't do it, but it's more emphatic, more like to the point, don't do it under any don't be doing this.
Don't go
breaking my heart. It's the same as saying don't be breaking my heart. When you say, there is a slight difference, because here it's more like don't keep doing this. She's already brokenhearted. He's already brokenhearted. So it's almost like saying, stop doing it now. Mm-hmm. When you say, don't go breaking, it's because they already have been.
And she said, and she answers, I couldn't if I tried.
So because she doesn't think that she has broken his heart when she said that. I couldn't if I tried. Meaning, if I broke your heart, it wasn't on purpose. I don't think that I did. Only in this short sentence, she's saying this.
And then what do you mean when he said, oh, honey, if I get restless?
Restless. When you can't sleep at night.
When excited.
You don't know what to do. You're tired, but you can't rest. Mm-hmm. You feel that you're a bit sleepy, but when you try to sleep, you can't. You don't know what to do.
Okay, like this way. Passionate, or
it could be like that, but it could also mean like under other circumstances.
Okay.
If you
and,
like,
and she says, "Baby, you are not that kind."
This could be taken in two different ways. You're not that kind, meaning you're not that generous. You're not a generous person, or it could be you're not the type of person who would get your heart broken. We have to ask Elton John to know. And you know what?
Not that kind of.
Maybe one day we'll get the chance to ask Elton John.
He came
here, wasn't he?
He was here 1 week ago, I think.
And we missed our chance.
We missed our chance. No, it was sold out.
It was sold out.
No, we're no chance to ask anything.
So it could be kind as in generous, or kind as in type, that type of person. So we could interpret it in two different ways.
That is a perfect song, because the lyrics are
perfect. Here, to ask, baby, is it baby or?
Babe.
Yeah.
Babe, okay.
Babe,
that's
good,
a great one, because
good
you
point.
Have, all right.
We always see this in lyrics.
Babe. It can mean a gorgeous woman.
Ah.
She's more than beautiful. She's a babe. She's gorgeous. Mm-hmm. She's a gorgeous woman. A gorgeous woman. Or babe as in darling or honey.
Okay,
And now there's a new one that started recently. Babe. Mm-hmm. This is new. This is 2000s.
Oh, babe.
It's the same as babe or baby. The same meaning.
Oh.
And then some people will say like, oh, she's my babe. You say, yeah, she's my babe. It's like, she's my girlfriend. She's my baby.
Mm-hmm.
These all derive from baby in a romantic way of referring to somebody. In a romantic way.
Mm-hmm.
And but of course there are some men that say this to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very condescending to women, if you know what I mean.
Mm-hmm.
It's very condescending, like if you go in to do a job and they say, babe, sit down or have a seat, or it's I feel it's condescending and insulting. Mm-hmm. But there are some men who use babe, baby, and bae.
Yeah.
Very often to women.
Uh-huh. It's very there is an intention to support you also. Mm-hmm. You put this part in the flame. Mm-hmm. I've got your heart in my sights. You put this part to flame. Okay.
It's a metaphor for feeding the love. When you feed the fire, feeding.
Mm-hmm. But I've got your heart in my sights.
If you've got something in your sights, you want it. Mm-hmm. I said, well, I've got those shoes, and I want to go and buy them. I don't have the money now.
It's an expression.
I've got that in my sights. I want to buy
it.
It's something that you really want. I've got it in my sights.
In my sights. Really want it. That's all.
I'm never going to be able to start it. You have to start it. Where are you now? Are you? Time. This song, I think, is over 20 years old, but it doesn't age.
Very current.
But let's talk about the title, Linger.
Yeah,
what does that mean?
Yeah.
What does the verb to linger mean? You can venture a guess.
Yeah, I guess it's okay. Linger, to linger is to postpone. Or something.
No, it isn't. Not to postpone. No. Well, maybe you just stretch it a bit. It could be that, but not exactly.
Why?
To linger. All right. So let us talk about something. For example, think about a woman with French perfume. Very good perfume, the best quality, because they have some sort of element in them, chemical elements that make the perfume last longer. So the woman comes in, she talks and leaves, but her perfume lingers. You can still smell her perfume after the perfume lingers.
After
to
leave.
Stay behind. Mm-hmm. To stay behind.
To stay behind.
But in this case, it's very abstract, because here linger meaning he's not really there, or she's not really there, but the presence can be felt spiritually, emotionally, because it's like an unfinished relationship, to remain. Yes, it's a very good synonym for it, to linger, to remain.
But you said something different.
What did I say?
You said something not before. We said remain.
To stay behind.
To stay behind. Yeah. So to stay behind is something interesting. Stay behind. Okay, but the meaning here for me is to remain.
The feeling is still there.
If you could return, don't let it burn, don't let it fade.
So that why would she say that, to fade? Because you have
fade is something that is
to fade. To fade can mean a couple of different things. When you watch a movie, at the very end, the screen
fades out, it disappears,
right? Mm-hmm. So she's saying, don't let it fade.
Yeah,
don't disappear.
Keep it up.
Stay. It's almost like she's saying, but she or he is confused.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because she's still saying, where did I put the paper? Oh, there you go. Because she's still saying, why do you have to linger? And then there's a few things. In the very first, how do we know that this relationship has ended? How do we know?
Yes, it's an end. There is an end of this relationship, because she said, so why were you holding her hand?
Okay, so what was the problem there?
Is that the way we stand?
Yes, so there is, you found infidelity. This was the cause.
The cause of the break.
Infidelity.
Together, yeah.
What is a synonym for infidelity? I know what you're thinking. If a man cheats on a woman, or a woman cheats on a man, they are unfaithful.
Unfaithful.
So what is the noun? Infidelity, unfaithfulness. Mm. Very difficult to say. Very awkward word as well. Infidelity, unfaithfulness. So this person is singing a song, they broke up a relationship because of infidelity, unfaithfulness, but the feelings are still there. So she still loves him.
She or he were betrayed.
Yes, they were betrayed.
Betrayed. Mm-hmm. In her feelings.
Mm-hmm. And there are some synonyms to betray. Mm-hmm. To betray. To cheat. To cheat on somebody, or to play somebody.
Yeah, cheat is something. It's something that you're not fair. It's not fair.
To cheat is when, for example, in a card game, I take some cards and I put them here while I'm playing.
That's cheating.
On a test, like if I look at your answer and I copy Your answer, I'm also cheating.
Cheating, okay, cola.
Yes.
Cheating, okay.
So it's
there's a vocal in the introduction here, like this. Almost done.
If you could return, don't let it burn, don't let it fade. I'm sure I might be rude, but it's just your attitude. It's tearing me apart, it's ruining everything. Okay, there's one thing. Do you have my copy there?
Yes, I have.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Which one do you have?
I don't know the song.
No, I don't know.
Okay.
No, this one. Here we go.
But
because I made some changes, and I want you to find the changes while we sing.
Why you made changes? There's some error?
I put some antonyms in there to what was there. So.
Okay, let's try it.
You're doing very well.
This song.
Thank you. I think it's so difficult, Daddy. Don't let it burn, don't let it fade. I'm sure I might be rude, but it's just your attitude. It's tearing me apart, it's ruining everything. I swore I would be true, and honey, so did you. So why were you holding her hand? Is that the way we stand? We're lying all the time. Was it just a game to you? But I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? Trying not to lie, things wouldn't be so confused, and I wouldn't feel so used. But you always really knew I just want to be with you. But I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You've got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? Now, pronunciation-wise, there is one thing that a lot of people don't realize, that this is not, this here is not a GER. In either of these, Linger.
Linger.
Linger. It's a sound linger. That it's linger. Not g and it's not ny. It's linger.
Oh.
Linger. Linger.
Ah.
It's not a
finger. Finger. Finger.
Finger. That's
finger.
Wrong.
Finger. It's like that. No.
On top of top. It's at the
top
very top.
Nose.
The top of your mouth. The
finger.
Ceiling of your
finger.
Mouth.
Finger.
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 Yes.
Finger.
Finger.
Almost. Almost. Finger.
Almost. Yeah.
Oh.
You can interpret it like that. Finger. Finger.
Okay. And you made a change in the
lyrics. I made some changes, yes.
Yeah, I saw who I love you. You made.
I thought the world of you. I found the version that I found on the internet was I thought the world of you, but I found
world?
Other. I thought the world of you.
What it means?
I thought you were the most magnificent person in the world. I trusted you. I thought you were wonderful. I thought you were this.
I thought
the world of you.
Oh, sorry.
I thought this is the word actually.
It's another version. I don't know which one is
correct. I'm not sure either.
Yeah.
I always, but you know what happens though when you hear a song and you think you hear something and you always sing that.
Yeah.
There's, you know that song, Hold Me Closer, Tiny Dancer. Have you heard the song?
No.
And a lot of people, when he says Tiny Dancer, a lot of people think you're saying Tony Danza. So a lot of people sing Hold Me Closer, Tony Danza. instead of Tiny
this,
Dancer.
This song, I would like to record.
To record it?
Yeah.
All right.
I have a very good microphone here. So I, we can try.
Yeah.
I can put it here for you to sing.
And what did you say? The fourth and nine, you change. I like to be polite instead of polite. You say something else.
Rude. Yeah, it was the opposite.
Uh huh. Okay.
And then where it says fake,
okay.
True.
Yeah. And the right and wrong.
Exactly. Yeah.
Did you find it in the internet?
No, I changed it just because the theme of today was antonyms.
Mm-hmm.
So,
okay. Let's rehearse one more time,
mm-hmm.
and then we try to record.
Sure.
I think it will be nice.
You really sung very well.
Yeah.
I'll try to do this.
If you could return, don't let it burn, don't let it fade. I'm sure I'm not being rude, but it's just your attitude. It's tearing me apart, it's ruining everything. And I swore I would be true, and honey, so did you. So why were you holding her hand? Is that the way we stand? Were you lying all the time? Was it just a game to you? But I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? Oh, I thought the world of you. I thought nothing could go wrong. But I was wrong. I was wrong. If you could get by trying not to lie, things wouldn't be so confused, and I wouldn't feel so used. But you always really knew I just want to be with you, and I mean it someday. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? So deep, you know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger?
Try to record.
All right. No, just because we're going to record, I'm just going to.
Yeah.
Don't worry, don't worry.
So,
just,
what did you say if you got shallow?
Deep.
Deep.
Yeah, shallow? Deep. Shallow waters. I only swim in the shallow waters.
Really?
No, I don't. Okay. This is the official one.
Oh.
How do you say English when you don't sing very well? There's something
that. Yeah, but I can't carry a tune.
Out of tune.
Yeah, well, I can't carry a tune. Okay, so you tell us. You're the director. You tell us. If you could return, don't let it burn, don't let it fade. I'm sure I might be rude, but it's just your attitude. It's tearing me apart, it's ruining everything. I swore I would be true, and honey, so did you. So why were you holding her hand? Is that the way we stand? Were you lying all the time? Was it just a game to you? But I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? Ooh, I thought the world of you. I thought nothing could go wrong. But I was wrong. I was wrong. If you could get by trying not to lie, things wouldn't be so confused, and I wouldn't feel so used. But you always really knew I just wanna be with you. But I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. To let it linger. Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? and I mean it so deep. You know I'm such a fool for you. You got me wrapped around your finger. Do you have to let it linger? Do you have to? Do you have to? Do you have to let it linger? So this is something that I used to do this in Brazil to teach English with music once a week. Mm-hmm. This was the time there was no internet. Mm-hmm. So the other teacher and I, we didn't have the record, the big vinyl with the lyrics. We had to go to a store and ask the owner, can we copy?
Yeah.
This is so different now. I keep thinking now these people have it so easy. Take a picture.
Yeah.
And we sat there copying.
You'll never forget the song.
Yeah.
Because once you work with the music, it's got.
It got stuck to your head.
Yeah. When you in the refrain, or sometimes you call refrain or chorus.
Chorus or refrain.
Chorus,
are both correct.
Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. So you say, but I mean, but I'm in so deep.
I'm in it. There's an it missing from me.
Ah,
I'm in it.
And I mean it so.
And I mean it so.
Ah, okay. Mean it. Mean it.
I'm in it.
I'm in it. Ah.
But you know what? I have seen a different variation of this. I've seen somebody say, I mean it. I've seen somebody say this, but then it would be grammatically incorrect.
Yeah.
I mean it so deeply.
I'm in it.
So deep, meaning I'm all the way down.
You know I'm such a fool for you. It's okay. You got me wrapped.
Wrapped around your finger.
You say, you got me wrapped around your finger.
I used to say,
you got me wrapped. No. Wrapped around.
You have to say all of it together. Wrapped around.
Like a wrap.
Actually, no. It's think about this. Like I'll do anything that you want me to do. You have me wrapped around.
For you.
I'm, you know, like anything you say jump. I'll say how high do you want me to jump? So you say, you say when somebody's completely in love with somebody else, you say, oh, she's got him wrapped around his finger because he's so, you know, in love with her.
But do you have to let it linger?
Do you have to let it linger? She doesn't want to feel the love anymore. She doesn't he cheated. How I understood it, he cheated on her. She thought he was this wonderful person. She thought the world of him. And he was actually a jackass.
Yeah.
So why, she's asking, why do you have to let it linger? Why do you have to let me still feel this? The feelings lingered.
Mm-hmm.
The relationship ended, but the love lingered.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Another point. Can I ask?
Sure. Go ahead.
I saw the world of you. Okay. I said that nothing could be wrong, but I was wrong. If you could get by,
yes.
Try not to lie.
What is to get by? Do you understand to get by?
No.
The expression.
No.
For example, you know what? Like I'm living my life. I'm surviving. I'm not living fully. I'm surviving.
I'm just
getting by. I don't have enough money, but I have enough to pay my bus fare.
Mm-hmm.
I have enough to eat a sandwich, but I don't have a lot to buy somebody a gift. I'm just getting by.
Mm-hmm.
So if you could survive without lying, meaning that he probably lies all the time.
Oh, okay.
Could you be yourself without lying? Could you get by? It's probably such a major part of his personality that he always lies. So could you not lie? is asking you not to love.
But it's not easy to understand. If you could get by
trying
not to lie, things wouldn't be so confused.
Yeah, the reason why she's so confused is because he lies all the time. He can't survive, he can't live without lying. It's such a major part of his life. He lies all the time. So she's confused. She never knows, is this true or what is he doing? So if he didn't lie, she would be so
confused. Okay, but she said, okay, things wouldn't be so confused and I wouldn't feel so useless.
And she feels
but like, you mm-hmm. always ruin you.
But you always really knew. That's what I'm saying. That's what I've been saying. You always really knew.
We have to find which version.
Which version is correct?
You always
really knew. It makes more sense this way, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Some of the songs that we find on the internet are people that they copied it off the lyrics from the charts, from the CD. But some people listen and they think they hear something and they write.
Yes, all the time.
You know, Forever in Blue Jeans, there's a song, Forever in Blue Jeans. Mm-hmm. And there's a guy who's saying, Reverend Blue Jeans.
No, when I was young, I used to sing, because I love to sing and play and sing. I used to sing in English from very...
A very early age.
So we used to sing the way we listen.
You heard it, yeah.
Sometimes it's made big mistakes.
Oh, yeah.
But it's funny, no problem.
Yeah.
I think it's a very good song to explore. And this.
There is a lot of, this is almost like a poem.
Because
he has a lot of, there's a lot of layers underneath what's there. It's not just what's there. And there's a lot more into it. And then, is that the way we stand? In this case here, what do you think stand means, to stand? Because you have different meanings for to stand. To tolerate is one of them.
Mm.
I can't stand the coldness.
Mm.
To stand. Or to stand isn't to be up. Stand up to be up.
Yeah.
But in this case here, it means something else.
Stand with hands on, shake it.
No, up. In this case here, where do we stand? What's our situation now?
Because she said,
is that
so
the way?
Why were you holding her hand?
Now, is that the way we stand, you and I? So now you're holding somebody else's hand. So what is our situation? What is our situation? Are we still together? Are we not? So to stand in this case is to have a particular situation in place. It's a very long explanation. So, for example, we have a meeting, a business meeting, and at the end of the meeting, I say, okay, so how do we stand? Does everybody agree?
Mm-hmm.
How do we stand? What is the conclusion of this? So, to have a particular situation in place, what is the situation in place right now? Where do we stand?
The betrayal.
So is that the way you stand? So, are you betraying?
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's
it's not possible to stand like this.
Is that the way we stand? Is that the situation now?
Okay, but it's not possible to keep on doing that.
I'm sure that's is in between the lines, but this line itself, is that the way we stand? It's like, is that the situation now that you're seeing other people?
Let me check your lyrics.
What I have.
Totally different my
Is that the way we stand?
Is that the way we stand?
What do you have? You have
that. Is that the way we stand? Okay.
You have the same.
But it's like making a question.
It is a question. Is that the way we stand?
It must be a question mark.
There should be a question mark there.
Is that the way we stand? Were you lying, were you lying all the time? Was it just a game to you? Yeah, it's very clear in that album.
Yeah, I thought the way to see it, it's got the situation in place here. But this you can use in an academic sense as well. In the end of a presentation, if you want to know, okay, this is where we stand. From this point on, this is what's going to happen. When you present somebody with how a situation is, you say, this is how we stand. This is where we stand.
And sometimes I've heard this term. When somebody is on the stage, give thanks to the and the Oscar goes to, and then somebody goes and I'm standing here, receiving this prize, but it's mean a lot of hard work from other people.
Exactly.
From the teamwork.
You can also say, I stand here today. I'm standing or I stand. In this situation, the grammar goes off the window.
Yeah.
Out the window.
I stand
or I'm standing. Both of them are.
I'm standing here today. Thank you. But it's a kind of hard work from other people.
So you can.
Big team working.
It's almost like you're saying, my standing here today, it stands for
it's
what
a
everybody
result,
else. Yeah,
it's a result
going, yeah.
of teamwork. Yeah.
So you can use that at the end of.
Yeah, when I receive the Oscar, I will win.
Well, I practice with a shampoo bottle.
Oh, no, the Grammy. I received the Grammy. The Grammy.
The
Grammy, because the Oscar was music.
Yeah. I always, when we named Skylar, I always thought, Natalie Skylar Nielsen, if she one day becomes an actress, and the Oscar goes to Natalie Skylar Nielsen, doesn't it sound like somebody doesn't, she doesn't like it. But it's,
this song's the reach of.
Yeah, there's a lot to explore in there.
In there,
because I'm pointing. I'm pointing to it.
There. Okay.
So another activity that I would do on a night like this, if we had a bit more people, it's fun to do. You start playing a song that most people know, and then you turn down the sound completely, and people have to shout out what comes next.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have a lot of songs by Michael Jackson. People will know these songs. Mm-hmm. So I want to try just a couple of them with you guys to see how you do. But don't be shy. You have to jump in.
I have a lot of songs here.
I want to try a couple of things. He has a very rich repertoire. Okay, I'll see. I want to try this one on you guys and see how it goes.
The best song. It's a very good song. On board time.
This one is 30 seconds long.
Having
a barbecue. I just want to try a couple of things on you guys to see how you do. Okay. You've heard this one before, right? But I want to see if you'll do what I'm expecting you to do. The sound is loud. So, what do you picture when you hear the song? It's fun to stay at the I was hoping you'd do this. Y-M-C-A. And what? Do you know where that comes from?
No.
The Y-M-C-A. The village people.
Village
do you remember how they dressed?
Yes.
Yeah.
So a lot of people didn't know at the time that they were gay.
Yeah.
But also the YMCA, it's a place where young men can go and have a shower if they need it. They have sports. It's for people who don't have a lot of money. Or young kids, young boys, young men, Christians Association.
ASEAN.
Yeah.
In Brazil, we have ASEAN.
YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association.
Associação Cristã de Moço.
Yes. Young Men's Christian Association. But because it was just boys, a lot of couples developed and situations developed, so they made the song, the YMCA. Nobody knew at the time. At the time, nobody knew. Okay, so did you have some songs that you wanted to share? Yeah, we have time for a couple more.
Yeah. So, have we finished with this three songs? Okay.
Yeah.
So let me introduce one more. This is okay.
Mais da filha.
Thank you.
Well, I had never heard the song before, the first time.
No, it's very famous.
Bobby, I'm sure it is.
Bobby Marley song.
Wow. Okay. All right. Yeah, we're getting ready to wrap up today. So thank you so much for coming. It was lovely.
There's a stand here.
I always wonder why more people don't show up for something like this.
Yeah,
so we'll what Juliana will have here at the school in Spanish, in other languages, in Italian.